Ready to veni vidi vecchi?
I'm ready to talk to Tessa.
Just try to keep in mind that your memory of her is 10.
Yeah, well, it wouldn't be if she reached out to me while I was in Fireweed, which she didn't. So I'm guessing this is Michael?
Hey, you.
Hey, isn't it your day off?
Yep, we're here as patrons. Tyler, meet Michael. This is the annoying coworker I was telling you about.
I was there for your introduction of marshmallow vodka and wine coolers, and I've only worked my way up to annoying coworker. Rude.
Don't worry, she told me exactly how miserable she'd be in this town without you.
It's so good to finally meet you. The Tyler talk goes on 24/7, so I feel like I already know you. So, you here to grab some stuff for the homestead, or...?
Yeah, we decided it'd be easiest if we just stayed out there. We'll get it cleaned up faster if we literally cannot escape it.
Hey, I'm all for efficiency. Cannot wait for us to get out of here.
What's that?
Oh, Michael is moving to Juno, too.
Oh. And did you guys plan on moving together, or...?
Well, I mean, yeah. It'll be cheaper to share a place, but nothing's set in stone.
Makes sense.
There could be room for you, too.
For sure. The more Ronins, the merrier. I'm studying to be a chef, so, you know it'll be good eating. And hey, I only snore during allergy season. And baseball.
How can I say no to that?
You okay?
Dead on my feet, girl. Got up at 4 to fish before work. It's been a day.
Oh, you like to fish?
Yeah, there's this spot called Buzzard Hole I go to at least twice a week. It's like an hour drive, but it's so chill, especially first thing in the morning.
Shut up, I used to go there all the time.
For real?
Yeah.
Hey, well, if you want to go sometime, holler at me. I don't mind sharing.
Cool, most guys I know get all smeagol about their fishing spots.
Oh, look at you two, bonding over the most slow and boring way to kill an animal.
She's just jealous because she couldn't catch a fish, even if she filled the lake with cyanide first.
Never mind. Tyler, we better get started with our shopping.
Yeah, I'll be around if you need anything.
Well, hello, Miss Ronan. Did you forget something in the office?
No, just doing some shopping. You remember my brother, Tyler?
Your brother? Oh, right, Tyler. What a pleasant surprise.
Didn't Allison tell you I'd be by today?
Yes, I think she did. I just didn't expect to see such a dapper young man.
Well, I did shower this morning.
Did you just get back into town, or...?
More or less. We've been working out at the old house. But, surprise, surprise, after 10 years of sitting empty, it was missing a few things. Hence the supply run.
Ah, right. Well, we'll get you set right up. It must be nice to be home.
I'm not sure nice is the word for it.
Oh, of course. I assume being there feels... complicated.
That's one way to describe it.
Well, don't let me keep you any longer. I'll be here if you need anything.
Oh, hey, is Tessa around today?
The wife's not in at the moment. I'm sure she'll be around later, though.
Okay, so we need candles and an all-purpose cleaner.
Plus snacks and drinks. I'm starving. You think you could take a picture of this? Look, all the good fishing spots are marked.
I don't have my phone on me. And you know you could just Google all this later, right?
Are you kidding, Allison? Old fishermen aren't gonna share this kind of juicy intel on the internet. No way! The Trout King is still here.
Hey, have you still not picked anything out?
Oh, remind me what we need again.
Repeat after me. An all-purpose cleaner, candles, drinks, and some snacks. Any opinion on cleaning products?
Only that using them is an unfortunate way to spend an afternoon.
I'll take the strong one.
Ew, canned ham? How do people eat this?
Ugh, snob much? It's not that bad.
Weren't you the picky eater when we were kids?
Tyler, you want water, soda, juice?
Whatever you want. I'm not picky.
Wish any of it sounded good. Grape soda it is.
Ooh, getting wild.
What do we still need to get?
I haven't found the candles yet. I haven't decided what snacks I want either.
Choice paralysis is a thing. Inventory, huh?
Yeah. My mind is so numb right now. Anyway, how's the shopping spree going? Finding everything you need?
Yeah, I'd be done already, but I'm letting Tyler browse and take it all in.
Must be weird for him to be back here.
Yeah, I don't know. But today's been crazy.
Define crazy.
It was just kind of unsettling to go back to the old house after all this time.
How are you feeling?
Still unsettled, but it'll pass.
All right. Well, I'll be here if you need me.
Hey, if we buy ice cream, we can keep it cool in the snow.
Ice cream? In 20-degree weather?
Ice cream in all weather.
Hey, Tyler. Candy or chips?
You know I got a sweet tooth, sis.
Sugar rush it is. Let's see. Fresh cut peonies, triple layer chocolate chip cake, toasted marshmallow.
Are you doing a dramatic reading of a fancy ass cookbook?
Nope. Just browsing these fancy ass candles. You only live once.
It's not dead.
Okay, I think we're done here.
Tom will ring us up at the counter.
Aren't you running for more gun control?
My platform calls for sensible regulations, but folks around here need guns for safety.
Allison,
and as you know, we run extensive background checks before each and every sale.
Hmm.
Will that be all?
Yes. Thank you, Tom. Oh, hi, Tessa. We were just meaning to come talk to you.
Hi, Tessa. Long time no see.
My God, you look like a completely different person.
It's me. Plus beard.
Yes.
So we were out at the old house today.
Heavens, why would you go there? Surprised it's even still standing.
We found some stuff in Marianne's room that took us by surprise.
Oh, really?
We want to ask you some questions about her. You're the only person who might have known Marianne better than us.
I don't know about that. It's been a decade, kids.
I know, but I need to ask.
What is it?
Did she ever talk about me being a boy?
No. It never came up. I found out much later, just like everybody else.
Marianne was obviously concerned. She really didn't confide in you at all?
Your mother was intensely private. She didn't need anyone else, and she made that clear.
But this was about Tyler. She was always willing to ask for help when it came to us.
Not at the end. Look, I have a lot on my plate today. I'm sorry. My advice to you would be to try to move on.
It's not that easy.
What happened that night? You can't understand something like that, but it was God's plan. That's all we can know. I need to go now. Best of luck to you, truly.
What the hell was that?
I told you she wouldn't talk. It's like she's got CIA training.
Something's weird here. It's weird, right?
Yeah, I feel it too. It's like something's on the tip of my tongue. Hey guys, you all done yet?
Yeah, Mom. Can we go outside while you and Tessa play cards?
I'm afraid there's no time for games today, sweetie. Now let's go.
Marianne, can you come here?
Sorry, Tessa, I'm in a bit of a hurry.
Oh? What's your excuse this time? Emergency repairs for the Beaver Dam?
Tessa, look.
No, I don't want to hear it. I want to talk to you now.
Hey guys, you all done yet?
Yeah, Mom. Can we go outside while you and Tessa play cards?
I'm afraid there's no time for games today, sweetie. Now let's go.
Marianne, can you come here?
Sorry, Tessa, I'm in a bit of a hurry.
Oh? What's your excuse this time? Emergency repairs for the Beaver Dam?
Tessa, look.
No, I don't want to hear it. I want to talk to you now. Or do I need to start calling in your debts?
I'd completely forgotten about that.
I remember it, but not exactly like that. Here, let's see if we can call up my version, okay?
Mom? Can we go outside while you and Tessa play cards?
No, there's no time for games today.
Marianne? Can we talk?
No, we can't. Just leave the groceries, kids. Let's go.
Don't. Please, let's just talk for a few minutes. Okay?
Okay. We remember that slightly differently. I guess that makes sense. Rashomon, you know? But whatever happened. After that, they walked to the counter, and then Marianne lashed out at Tessa, right?
No.
I want to talk to you now. Or do I need to start calling in your debts?
No, Tessa was. She went all Jack Thompson on her.
I want to talk to you now. Or do I need to start calling in your debts? The Lord disciplines those he loves. You're failing these kids, Marianne.
Judge me all you want, but don't spew that hate around my children.
Spew hate?
I am trying!
Your friend! They need a firm, guiding hand, and you!
Oh my God! You actually think you're being a friend right now? Talking about my children that way?
Yes, you might find this hard to believe, but friends aren't just for loans, Marianne.
You really want to get into this? Fine. Let's go to your office. I'll be right back, kids. You stay inside, okay? What is wrong with you?
I wish you would have trusted me on this. I really don't think Tessa was being that harsh.
You don't know her. And regardless of who started things, once they were in the office, they both went at it.
What do you think they were arguing about? Me?
Don't know. It was impossible to hear over the music. But hey, now that we know she was lying to our faces, let's ask her.
Is there something I can do for you?
Earlier you said Marianne kept everything to herself, but you two had a big fight a few months before her death, didn't you?
We argued all the time. You'll have to be more specific.
This wasn't about who cheated at Canasta. This was intense. You locked yourselves in the office so we couldn't hear.
I'm sorry. It was a long time ago. Now, I was in the middle of something.
Okay. We'll leave you to it. Damn it.
I think she knows more than she's letting on.
Duh. But there's no way to nail her down when we don't even know what we mean.
If we could pinpoint what it was about, she'd be out of excuses.
Sure, but how do we do that? The music was too loud to make out what they were saying. Mm.
Marianne and Tessa were obsessed with that song. It was on all the time.
What are you thinking?
We've been getting these visions whenever we see or hear something really emotional. Maybe listening to it will trigger something.
You may be onto something here, Ronan.
We can't go back to her with anything half-assed. We should go talk to Tom. Make sure we build as strong of a case as possible.
Okay. Let's see if we can figure out what song it was. Hey, Tom.
There's something I can help you with?
This might be a weird question, but do you remember the song that Tessa and Marianne used to love? They played it all the time?
How could I forget? I think she's still got the CD back here. A little worse for the wear, of course. Hold on. Here it is. I was happy when it got put away, to be honest. A bit cheesy for my tastes.
This is it, right?
I just got hit with a flood of memories. You seen what I'm seeing?
Yeah.
Should we check this one out?
Mom, stop! That's so embarrassing!
Oh, yeah? Tessa, come join me. I know you love this song.
No, I couldn't possibly. Some of us are actually trying to get work done here.
I forgot how carefree she could be.
Yeah. What the hell happened?
Do you think there's more memories lurking around?
I don't know. Let's see.
Kids keep pestering me for these candies, but they're so expensive.
I'll just grab a bag. It's fine.
Oh, no. I can't, Tessa.
It's nothing.
Okay. But write it down in your little notebook.
Okay, okay. Whatever you want. There. Happy?
Yes. And I'll be by on Wednesday to help you close, like I promised.
Tessa acted like she was Marianne's mom sometimes.
I think you mean Tessa was self-righteous and treated Marianne like a charity case.
She was trying to help.
We should see if we can find that notebook she was holding. I know Tessa still keeps a bunch of them in here somewhere.
What are you doing here?
I thought you needed help with the storm.
I needed help 2 hours ago. Have you been drinking?
What? No, I just had a day, okay? I took a pill. I'm fine.
Marianne.
I said I'm fine. Kids, come on, let's go.
Wait, please. I have something for you. Take a look at this when you get home, okay? They can handle this confusion. I've been working with these people for years. They can help.
What do you think that pamphlet was Tessa gave to Marianne?
I don't know. I saw it in Marianne's room. It had a creepy vibe, but I didn't think much about it. It was bad, though. Like, maybe conversion therapy bad. I'm sorry.
Whoa. If this is true, I want to know how Marianne felt about it. And we need to hit Tessa with some hard proof.
I should write down their info for after the move. Athletic, graceful, and spirited. Sounds like you.
Sorry, I might be movie star handsome, but I can't act for shit.
Can you believe Tessa and Tom were ever young?
I heard that. I may have a little less going on in the hair department. But you should see the rest of Delos High, class of 81.
Fair enough.
Shouldn't we try to find something about the pamphlet Tessa gave Marianne?
Good idea. What was the organization called? The Alliance Against Other People's Business?
We should see if we can find that notebook she was holding.
Yeah. I think they're all piled up in Tessa's office somewhere.
Shouldn't we try to find something about the pamphlet Tessa gave Marianne?
Good idea. What was the organization called? The Alliance Against Other People's Business? Sorry, can you put the song back on?
Huh, here it is.
Hello there.
Are you here for me or my cigarettes?
Hey, you're more than just a pack of cigarettes to me. Taking a break already?
Yeah, I needed a moment of zen. Tessa's been on my ass all day. Look, I get one count wrong and she has to triple check everything, like we'd go full on Lord of the Flies if there was one too many frozen pizzas.
Kinda sounds like she has a good reason to doubt your commitment to the inventory process.
Oof, Brutus.
So your deadline for the culinary was Monday, right?
I turned in my application, mother dear.
Oh, I'm so excited. Are you excited?
Well, I will be once I know I got in.
I am not worried about that. Did you give them my recommendation letter?
No, hon. While that paragraph about my salmon puff recipe was truly moving, it doesn't work like that.
Just tell them I discovered Bourdain. Then they'll take my opinion seriously. Are you working tonight?
No, thank God. I've been pulling doubles all week. I'm working at the diner all day tomorrow, though. You want me to bring you anything?
I'm trying to cut out carbs and grease for a while.
Girl, you may as well just lay down in the dirt and let the bears take you, because that is no way to live.
Later.
We should see if we can find that notebook she was holding.
Can I help you, Allison?
Oh, no thanks. I'm good. I'm just looking for something that I forgot. 2004.
Anything interesting?
Show. It looks like Marianne started flaking on her debt in October 2004.
5 months before that night.
What's this doing here?
She plays Mabel in Witches of Eldom? What? Why would I know about some silly show for teenage girls?
Tessa? Is it okay if I run a quick Google search? My phone's dead.
Sure, but make it quick. I'm going to need the computer.
Virtue Seekers Youth Camp. Wait, what? Is that what she recommended for Tyler?
I don't know what to say.
Tyler?
Yeah.
Let's see how Tessa explains this one away.
I think we've seen enough.
Yeah, we've got a good sense of what went down. Let's talk to Tessa.
Is there something I can do for you?
We're back, with details that should help your memory.
Oh, really?
Yes, really. We were buying groceries, and then you stormed in, threatening to call in debts and demanding that Marianne talk to you. It turned into an argument. So you guys went into the office and blasted that song you used to dance to all the time.
Call in debts? I never. Like I'm some kind of loan shark. When did this supposedly occur?
Well, our memories don't exactly have timestamps.
I can't be expected to take these accusations seriously if you can't even recall basic details.
April 2004. Isn't that when she stopped trying to pay off her debts?
Mm-mm. No, that doesn't sound right. I'm sure we never fought about money, though. I was always forgiving with your mother. I could see how she was struggling.
Yeah, and you loved lording it over her, didn't you?
Allison.
Excuse me? Young lady, I help others because it's the right thing to do. You all would have starved if it weren't for me.
And we're grateful for that. It's just an emotional subject for us, right, Allison?
Yeah. I never said you two were arguing about money. You said she was failing us and called her a bad parent. Was she done being judged by you? Was that it?
I really have no idea what you're talking about, and I was never cruel to Marianne. Everything I could to help her, to help you all. Even when she fought me, even when she screamed and spit in my face for the effort, even when she didn't deserve it.
What the hell is that supposed to mean?
Calm down. Look, we know you took care of us, and we're grateful, but I really need you to answer one question. When you two fought, was it ever about me?
It was always about a lot of things. She was struggling with everything at the end.
Did you try to convince Marianne to send Tyler to some kind of program?
No, and I think you should go now.
Tessa, I'm here to figure out if Marianne tried to kill me because of who I am. Do you get that?
I do, I just...
Then why won't you give us a straight answer?
I truly don't know what went on in her mind that day. And it will always be my deepest regret that I didn't see it coming. Now, I understand that this is an emotional topic for you both, and fortunately for you, I keep forgiveness at the heart of my relationships.
You're so fucking righteous. Why did you dump Marianne when she was at her worst?
I will not be dragged back into this. You need to go, now.
Can we have our groceries?
Michael already put them in your trunk.
Cool. Bye, Tom. What are you thinking?
Just trying to wrap my brain around all that. You know, we might have actually gotten to the truth if you hadn't lashed out at her.
Are you serious right now?
You were on her case the whole time.
Don't turn this on me. It's obvious she's guilty of something, and that's why she doesn't want to talk about it. Ugh, that sanctimonious bitch!
Done now? You get all that out of your system?
Sorry, I got so worked up. It just makes me crazy that she would play dumb like that. She knows how important this is to us, to you.
Yeah, but you know, you're onto something with the guilt. She didn't want to admit what they thought about, which makes me think it was me. You spooked her with that talk about the program. I think Marianne really was trying to figure out how to support me before whatever the hell happened that pushed her over the edge.
You may be right.
Yeah. She stood up for me, Allison. She was still crazy Marianne, but... she saw me. I feel lighter. Like I've been carrying something around for the last 10 years, and... now it's gone.
I'm really happy for you.
But...
that just opens a whole new box of Pandora's, doesn't it?
Yeah, a whole damn shipping crate full.
Well, it's a good thing Eddie's expecting us. He knew Marianne pretty well, and he was in charge of her case.
Did he ever mention anything about the investigation to you?
No, I never asked. And I'm sure he thought I was better off not knowing.
Guess that might have made for some awkward dinner conversation.
Exactly. But I mean, he's a good cop. Thorough. I'm sure he's got something. Let's go.
This is kind of bleak.
It's usually more crowded, but the other officers punch out at 6 o'clock sharp.
There's no crime after 6?
In the mean streets of Delos Crossing? Just bears and drunken disorderlies. And Uncle Eddie can usually handle them on his own.
But what about drunk bears?
Anyway, he's probably in his office, upstairs.
Damn, they still got this creepy mascot, huh?
What? Officer Justin Beaver is not creepy. He's Delos Crossing's longest-serving officer.
Hold on. I want to catch up on all the Delos Crossing gossip.
Oh, that's all just public safety stuff. Nothing that interesting. Home sweet home.
You spent a lot of time here growing up?
Yeah, whenever Eddie was working. The whole precinct's basically family.
It's freezing in here.
Oh, Greg's. Just leaving this out on display again.
Greg's? Like Officer Greg's? The one who was with us that night.
Yeah, he's still here. He became a bit of a local celebrity after nabbing a murderer from Juno. The guy was hiding out on a fishing boat and got really, really sick after eating out of the chum bucket. So it was actually a pretty easy takedown.
Come on, man. We can't make these poor kids sleep here.
I can't believe they're still. Well, where do you suggest they go? Social services will be here in a few hours, and this is the only room with a bed.
Anywhere but a cell. We'll find some other place.
Here we go again.
God, not here too. I'm not ready.
Me neither.
You remember Dan and Shelby?
I think so. The high schoolers who were always pissing Tessa off because they would blast fish and make out in the Vecchi's parking lot.
Yep. Dan's a cop now. They're married and have a kid, a dog, the whole shebang.
Damn. When did everybody decide to become an adult?
That's Denise Wilson's desk. Remember her?
Crazy D? The woman who set fire to her ex's trailer?
Oh no, it was her birthday. I completely forgot.
You're a terrible person.
It's your fault. I was so excited to see you that it completely slipped my mind. Remember this fella?
No way. Is that Jet?
Yep. He died last year putting himself between Dee and a bear.
Damn. Poor Dee.
She's obsessed with sled dog races now.
Is that even a thing?
Oh yeah. She goes to the Iditarod every year, and she's got a fantasy league called Musher's Little Helpers. It's really cool.
Man, I forgot what kind of kooky shit people are into out here.
Hey now, I'm in the league. She's gonna give me so much crap for forgetting her birthday. Looks like she forgot her locker key here.
Damn it.
Something's in the way. Tyler, you coming?
Allison, hey. Just finishing up a call. Trying to convince Melinda the Ravens and her garbage aren't police business. Give me a few minutes.
Sure.
Make yourselves a cup of coffee. Here's the key to the break room.
Thanks.
Come back upstairs when you're done, okay?
Coffee sound good? The machine is in the break room downstairs.
Uh-huh.
Those memories in some deep, deep part of my brain.
Same here.
I'm just gonna sit down in here and I'm gonna ask you a few questions, okay?
Okay.
You okay?
Yeah. I just usually try my best not to remember that night when I'm here.
I would too.
Something's in the way. Okay, let's go in.
Allison, how about that coffee we were talking about?
Ugh. They've let this place get gross. How is it still warm? You sure you want coffee this late in the day? You'll be up all night.
I don't think I'll sleep much anyways. Too much on my mind.
Those dusty couches won't make it any easier. Hey, you okay?
Stick to the plan. Come on, don't freak out on me now. I can't. Please, I can't lie. We already lied. It's all gonna be fine, okay?
You okay?
Honestly, no. Do you ever regret?
No. No way. Well, maybe once or twice early on, but now, no way. I mean, look where we're at. Look where I'm at.
Uncle Eddie's probably done by now. We should go find him.
Do you mind if I go inside that room for a second?
You sure? Uncomfortable, he dropped a vase.
Here. Have a seat.
All right.
Ah, damn it.
Sorry.
Huh, they kept this?
What?
It's that vase. They glued it back together. Back there. No way. Have you been hiding back here all this time?
Why did you separate us? Is Ollie okay?
Ollie's just fine, honey. They're all in the other room having cocoa. Everything's gonna be okay. I need to ask you a few questions now. Come with me.
You're awfully quiet.
Yeah, sorry. Trying to deal, but it's a lot. I'm not that hungry.
So, isn't Brown waiting for us? We should head back to his office.
This is heavier than I expected.
Hey, sorry that took so long. Sometimes these old folks want us to come out just because they're lonely.
No worries, Uncle. Hey, do you remember this guy?
Yeah, of course. How can I forget? Tyler Ronan, back in Delos Crossing.
It's good to be back.
And just look at you. A man grown.
Yep, guess I ate my Wheaties.
The whole clan's so proud of you. How you work with those kids at Fireweed. I would say, children.
I thought that was Whitney Houston.
Come on, bro. She stole her entire act from me. Everybody knows that. Look at you two. Reunited and it feels so good, huh?
Yeah, not sure how I got by without this dork. Look, Eddie. We aren't here just to say hi. We found something in Marianne's room. Things aren't really adding up anymore, and we've got questions.
Oh yeah?
Did anyone mention anything about her behavior in the days leading up to that day? Anything at all?
No. Everyone I talked to said it took them by surprise.
Did you see her at all? Like, in those last few days?
No. I hadn't seen her for weeks. Maybe a month before.
Did she mention anything about us that might have been worrying her? About Tyler in particular?
No. She dealt with those kind of worries all on her own. Kept the rest of us at arm's length.
I see.
I will tell you one thing, though. Your mom. Never knew her to hate anyone for being unconventional. Usually, it's the other way around.
Thanks, Uncle Eddie.
If you want my advice, nothing good comes from stirring up old memories.
We don't really have a choice about that.
There's always a choice, son. I know sometimes it doesn't seem like it, but There is.
Can we take a look at her file? Maybe we'd see something you didn't.
Her file?
Her case file, or police file, whatever you call it. You keep those pretty much forever, right?
We do, but I can't just pull it out right here, right now. There are procedures.
But you're the chief.
Which makes it even more important that I follow procedures.
Look, Chief Brown, are you gonna help us? Or are you gonna be a cop about
Tyler!
This?
No, it's fine. Tyler, I know you resent me, but fireweed was the best deal I could get you.
I'm not mad about fireweed. But I may be a little salty you kept my sister away for 7 fucking years.
That's what this is about? Look, that was the court's recommendation. They're the experts. I just went along.
Yeah, sure you did.
Trust me, son. We all believed that what happened that night was self-defense. But we couldn't be sure.
I can't believe this.
Look, we couldn't be sure, okay? I was trying to protect you both.
So you still not sure?
What?
You still think keeping us apart was the right call?
She was traumatized.
We needed each other to heal. And you took that away from us.
So why didn't you let your sister visit when you turned 18
Uncle,
then, huh?
Uncle, please. Let's move on.
She's never gonna tell you how much that hurt her. But it did.
That was about me. It wasn't about her. Allison gets that. And 3 years is nothing compared to 7. Right, Allie?
Look, Uncle, separating us like that did not help me heal. If anything, it was the opposite. Even if he had been dangerous, I'd have taken the risk. Being apart was that miserable.
I didn't know you felt that way, little Moose.
It was hard to talk to you about it. I didn't want to seem ungrateful. Look, we've all fucked up. And we've all hurt each other. But isn't that what family's for? Move on.
Sounds like the right call. Times like this, I wonder who raised who.
We're gonna stay the night at the old house. We better get going.
You wanna grab a bite first? It's on me. Don't wanna send you out there with empty stomachs.
I would not turn that down. Okay, let's go.
My hair. I won't do it again.
I'm going to kill you.
No, please, please, Mom. No. Mom, please. No, don't do this. Allison, we need to call for help. I killed her.
her.
No, you didn't. I killed her. And when they come, that's what we're gonna tell them.
No, no.
Yes, we look out for each other. That's what goblins do. And brothers and sisters. It's gonna be okay. We're gonna be okay.